And certainly something Sentinels is really good at doing, especially in the Valorant space as of late, whether they like it or not, I imagine they probably do, is they keep on making headlines. This case in particular, curious what you guys think about this one, as they've been known as the teabagging roster. The roster who in scrims or in matches seems to have a lot of fun with what they do, sometimes trolling, sometimes teabagging, sometimes running things they maybe should or should not be running. If you guys remember the argument between TSM Hazed and Sinatra many, many a months back, about their scrims between each other and that little TSM Sentinels rivalry. Well, it does continue as Valorant Masters Stage 2 Open Qualifiers are now underway. It's Shahzam having to explain in the round of 128 Open Qualifiers why the Sentinels trolled their matchup. They dominated the matchup, but he later goes on to explain why they were running Odins, teabagging, and especially what you saw time and time again is they were trolling by having just some crazy crosshairs.
Oh, I absolutely not fall away. Just has to take on the battle. The mosh pit of players, and he spotted out three of them at the edge of B main, and now the rest of the players, now that the information is there, they take a complete control of the main area, of the mid area. And, well, now they go out. Sig is up front. Sig gets a kill. So Put's trying to get a kill back, but it's never gonna work.
And then the run it back is what he got killed off of initially. And he ended up getting traded. That was just a chaotic round, okay? VNA, though, it was not the best situation to be put in because of the Sentinels pressure that has been on C. You try and counter it with a Showstopper, but there's nobody behind you to get that trade. So back to an eco here in Dapper. He's been lurking towards the A side. Well, no, it's a full push on in. Zom's TP's exactly under heaven. He's got an Odin ready for them and a Paranoia available to stop the push. 4 versus 5 as Sentinels a very comfy position right now.
It's having on the Neural Theft. Zom still with one of the best crosshairs I've ever seen in the game. Most likely gonna get this kill, right? But just because of the angle, right, you can't even see his head. And Flicks all went out their own individual battles. Now it's just Zom's. Oh my god, his crosshair got worse. So many players over on Cat. Shahzam takes down two. And it's all gonna come down to
a position where you're down 5 mil. This is, you know, a recoverable position. I'm not gonna
what
count them
on
out.
Earth?
Zom's. That,
That's trying to make their way into what is just a red sea of players on the A.
To which, very importantly, he does go on to explain as well, you know, how, first of all, he doesn't think Sentinels, after winning the first Master, should be in Open Qualifiers in the first place. We could certainly talk about that in the future if need be. I don't necessarily disagree with him on that point. Even more so, it was expected to be a wash this early on. They were having fun with it. And along with that as well, the opposing team, the NA, they actually showed up 30 minutes late. So a lot of people, or at least some people out there, seem to be very upset by the way Sentinels ran this matchup. Again, what do you guys think? But here is Shahzam explaining away some of those frustrations.
Why are you so disrespectful versus lower? Okay, why are you so disrespectful versus lower quality teams with troll crosshair drones, etc.? I thought you were a vet. Hey, this sounds like pretty serious and not like a troll, so I'm gonna explain this to you. One, we shouldn't even be in Open Qualifiers. It's a fucking waste of time. We spent 3 months qualifying for Masters through 3 different series, and we won the fucking tournament, and now 2 weeks later we're playing another Open Qualifier. It makes zero sense. We knew this game was gonna be a wipe. Being on the mainstream, it's boring to watch a team 13-0 team and try hard. It's honestly boring. So we had some fun with it. It's entertainment. Sports is entertainment. Esports is entertainment. That's the whole point of this. Have fun with it. And you know what? Overwhelmingly, more people enjoyed watching it, and fans of our team enjoyed watching that than watching us just sweat in 13-0 and go along with their day. Two, disrespect. You can't tell me it's disrespectful when the other team showed up 30 minutes late for the match. We sat there for 30 minutes waiting for them to download the client because they didn't do it ahead of time. So you can't say we were being disrespectful. We had fun with the match. We made it entertaining and we waited for them. Fair enough. Thanks for taking the time to respond. Okay. Stop taking things so seriously.
And I'm not really sure where I fall on this one. I mean, you guys know, I definitely agree with him on the fact they were having fun. They were definitely trolling around, maybe taking the crosshair thing a bit too far, but with the opposing team also showing up late. And again, I will agree, it was certainly more entertaining to watch them kind of stroll around and make fun of it as compared to actually just, as he says, sweating and sweeping the open quals. Again, round of 128. This is what we all expected. I think he makes a lot of great points in his argument. What do you guys think? Sentinels continue to be in headlines for Valorant for the for the right or wrong reasons. Either way, they're making headlines. What do you guys think? So far, their run throughout this stage two is what we all expected. Until next time, drink water, drink coffee, drink whatever you want, hydrate. I'll catch you back here sometime soon. Take care.